Hey, welcome to Psych Cinema, where we explore the psychology found in popular films, and today we're going to talk about the movie Lion. I'm Jonathan Heatherly. I'm going to walk you through some of the psychologically rich themes found in the film Lion, but before we do, let me give you just a brief synopsis of the film and my overall take. So Lion really centers on a little kid in India named Saru, who gets separated by his family, travels over 1,000 miles away, and because he may not be able to pronounce his town or his city's name accurately, he's eventually taken into an orphanage, and he's eventually adopted by an Australian family. And then the film really pivots to the second half, where the adult Saru, played by Dev Patel, really starts to reconnect with his memories and uses Google Earth, of all things, to help retrace where he grew up and to find his family. It's a really emotionally gut-wrenching film, but it's very inspirational. It's a very happy film. It will inspire you. It's very emotional. If you don't cry, you probably don't have a heart. But overall, I highly recommend it. But let's now talk about some of the psychology found in this film. So with Lion and with the character Saru, you walk through his sense of connection and attachment to his family, going through abandonment, and really what it means to be family. And this is something that I've explored actually in my own life as a child of adoption, but also working with other clients that have been adopted, and they sometimes struggle with questions of why did their family give them up for adoption? What was it about them that was not lovable? And so they struggle with this idea of what it means to be a family. That's not really anything that I struggled with, and you don't really see some of that traditionally play out in Saru's story, but you see a young man tormented by the recognition and knowledge that even though he had a very comfortable and positive life with his adopted family, he still can't shake the past of knowing that his family is out there. And so that's really where one of the core aspects of this film really focuses in on, is Saru's guilt and his empathy. And so it's not so much about his idea of like a sense of self or him feeling disconnected from his family. It's the guilt that he feels knowing that his family doesn't know what happened to him. And so that's one of the twists about this story, about a story of a kid that's adopted, was that he remembers his family. His family didn't abandon him. His family didn't give him up for adoption. He was separated from them. And as an adult, he is haunted by the knowledge that his mother, his brother, his sister, they don't know what happened to him. They don't know anything about him. And that's what really drives him to find his family, to be reunited with them. It's that sense of guilt, but also empathy. He can't tolerate knowing that they're in pain, knowing that there is no resolution or closure for them. And that eventually starts out to be a purpose, you know, a meaning in his life, but it eventually becomes an obsession. And you see in the character Saru how that purpose becomes an obsession to the point where it starts to be detrimental to his relationship and his ability to move forward in life. And so in some ways, this film actually can sort of be an illustration of how does someone deal with facing your past in order to move forward in one's life. Because once Saru, the adult Saru, starts to have all of these flashbacks about his childhood, and as he becomes more fixated about his mother and his family not knowing what happened with him, his adult life really comes to a halt. And all of the pursuits and all of the passions that he was following to really make a meaningful life as an adult, they come to a standstill. And it becomes an obsession that he can't move forward in life or in his relationships as an adult until he brings some type of resolution and closure to his family back in India. So if you have a chance to look at Lion, I highly recommend it. And let me know, what do you think about some of the psychology found in the film? And is there anything that I missed that you really think is important and pivotal to understanding Saru and the journey that he goes through? Well, that's going to be it for this episode of Psych Cinema. Be sure to check us out on YouTube, Facebook, any social media. You can also follow me on Twitter at @JHeatherly. Be sure to check back for more and more episodes where we look at the psychology found in popular cinema. But until then, I'm Jonathan Heatherly, and thanks for watching. Yay.